10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3.
Hamill's musical career started in 1968 when he formed a group called Van de Graaff Generator. They achieved international success with their records and live performances until they split up in 1977. For the last few years, Peter Hamill has been writing and recording music in the studio at his home near Bath and has just completed the songs for his new LP.
So the brief précis of the working life. I was a student, a science student, in 67, 68, and I'd been writing songs for a number of years, formed a group at university, and I found I had the opportunity to do this so laughingly called professionally, and that this was really what I wanted to do. I got something out of writing songs, performing them. I didn't get out of anything else. And so I left with one other person and started the group Van de Graaff. I mean, and naturally, in this world, success is the ethic, and normally that's in terms of numbers of records sold, numbers of people into concerts and what have you. That's a right ethic in many ways. I mean, it's a business as well. But I've had the grace, perhaps, having started at the time that I did, to see and believe, as I still do, that this form potentially can do more than that. Obviously, you know, any music has to be moderately successful in it simply to survive. But just as with movies, now the ethic is all, it's got to be an N million gross, and that's the only Hollywood term, success. The great movies not necessarily have on mega budgets and don't necessarily make anybody a lot of money, but something happens in the form. Now, I believe that that's also possible in rock music, and that it's a form that's both a commercial object, but that also can mean something to people. That is all we are. That is all a man comprises, chemicals alone, with no spirit, soul, or ghost. Nothing so bizarre, no amount of faith disguises. What is true is what we fear the most. Nothing can survive save the things men leave behind them. Any other case would be really too absurd. If thoughts remained alive, surely modern science would find them. No, the soul is nothing but a all the wonders man achieves emerge from cerebral tissue. Chemical reactions ebb and surge, form that thing that is you. It's a sad philosophy, but better sad than wrong. Face the truth instead, when you're dead, you're dead. When you're gone, you're a bag full of salt.
Not entirely sure where songs come from at all, or the moment at which they originate. A song like Shell I began to write years and years ago, I suppose, and it began actually with just the B chord, B major chord there. Now, of course, any tune, you've only got that from there to there, any melody has got to be within that number of notes, so it just appeared. And then quite early in this particular case, the knowing the life, or writing the life, appeared, and I actually wrote the whole song along that line, and then at some stage this Shell business came up as well. Now, when I was originally writing it, I just played this over and over again, that bit I've just played, and the song would have been 43 verses of that, endless repetition. And at some point, it became evident to me that it needed to have a sudden lift in the middle, so I consciously then set about finding this passage that... which is obviously building up towards the... I didn't sit down once I decided to write it in B. I didn't sit down and go, that would be a decent tune. My fingers were literally led along the way into the tune. And, you know, I mean, once if it's a genuine tune, then one remembers it instantly. You go, in the course of writing a song, as I say, you can go through... all the variants that you have, but finally the one that you know is right for this particular song comes up and it's... And that's a funny interval, that... And then this... There's funny stuff going on in there, but that was the right thing. It finds me.
Palatial residence. It's a garden that's open during the summer, and I'd like to come down here at least half a dozen times, see how the big clock of nature is going among the plants. And there's a static clock as well, lots of Rome and Florence that's been dropped down here in the middle of the English countryside. It's a place that can be neutral for me, where I can get out from the studio and normal pressure of world, like everybody else. Musicians and writers need to do that. And here it can be peaceful and tranquil and very busy at the same time. There's lots of collision of time and culture. And I need it and will continue to do so.
What I'm conscious of is I don't want to be predictable to myself. I consciously try not to rewrite the same songs. I've written a lot of songs over the years and recorded a lot. I don't think I've yet got into retread territory. Now, there are obviously a limit to the number of sweet and logical tunes that one can find. And I think what I tend to do is throw in what seems to me to be a natural way, elements of discord, funny time signatures, just to provide the difference, to provide the edge. There's often, in my songs as well, a lot of contrast where there's a sweet bit of lyric, I'll then juxtapose that with particularly hard or discordant music, and vice versa, just to get attention going in the song. This is, of course, not, again, normal rock music work. It's meant to be an easily eaten pill, rock music. I believe it's potentially more than that. I think one of the magical things about the song, or the pop song particularly, is it doesn't just have to be boy meets girl. You can slide in some quite strange ideas and some strange comments as well. For instance, there's an old song of mine, which is called and which is about Port and Dan, the research establishment in Wiltshire. And it's a funny idea for a pop song, but pop song it is. It's just, I used to drive past on coming back home from London, and it kind of broods on the skyline, and the strange stuff goes on in there. It's bang in the middle of the English countryside, and it's something that's ignored, virtually. It's, I wrote it at a time, particularly when, you know, naturally I'm concerned about, you know, the whole nuclear questions, and it seemed to me that, you know, one had forgotten about the chemical and biological end of things, and we ought occasionally just to say, look, this exists. It's horrible.
Won't hear a sound, or turn down. Clear the quits, keep the silence in underground. Or turn down the fast fall of the final violence. Of the future warfare hidden on the ground, and what a man far too frightened to utter what you are from Horton down, the clear liquids keep their silence. Hidden underground at Horton down, the fast form of the final violence. Hurry on round about Horton down, a quick glimpse of the future warfare. Hidden underground at Horton down, far too frightening to utter. What you saw there? No sound.
I mean, up until now, I've released at least a record a year with new material, and I haven't done that for a couple of years now. So I've obviously been taking stock of myself to a certain extent, my function within rock music, what kind of role I can perform, and also actually what subject matter still interests me. And, I mean, the bulk of the songs that I'm now writing continue things that have interested to the point of obsession. They've interested me to the point of obsession over the years. Mainly these are sex and time. And at the same time, I've tried to pull back from just being deliberately obtuse and making things difficult. But I'm still trying to write pop songs. You know, I don't want to... I mean, when I start talking like this, I talk and, you know, I jabber away a bit and the words come flooding out. And I know in the moment that I'm saying them that all this is absolutely meaningless. You know, my job, what I do, is I write songs. The reason that I write songs is that I think I can express something in the course of 3.5, 4 minutes, which means a great deal to me, about, say, about sex, about time, about society, the individual, what have you. And I can bang that into a song and it means something. The moment I start spouting away like this, it's exactly the opposite. You know, the whole reason for writing songs is to avoid talking, because I can't organize my thoughts. So that I'm continuing to do, in effect. And the conscious effort that I'm making is to try and produce songs which can be taken as utterly facile. If you want to take them as facile, they're pop songs. If you want to look at them in a more serious way, because I look at them in a serious way, you know, I'm not just messing around for 4.5 months recording and 2 years of writing. I'm not just doing it for the money or the fame. I'm doing it because it's important to me and I care about it. So if you want to look deeper in the songs, there's something there, I hope.
It's not that complicated.
Writing a song is, of course, internal, but it's much easier if there's somewhere that's blank, that's obviously has a kind of personality, but one that can be sat upon. Now, hotel rooms, obviously every room has its different personality. I mean, the number of people who've passed through this room, for instance, there will have been certain dramas here, certain peaks, but it doesn't stay in the room. So when I walk in and just dump down the guitar, dump down the clothes, it's my room. But I don't have a connection with it more than my passage of time here. And that means that these utterly random things that are the source material, really, of songs can be assembled.
usually I write a song now that pulls back something I remember from 10 or 12 years or so ago. So in a way one could say that the scratch point is when I had the thought or the insight 10 years or so ago that predestined the existence of the song I'm writing today. But it's quite feasible. It's a, particularly on a day off, something like that, when there's a lot of time to kill and one has the guitar, take the guitar out and just start playing and a little tune emerges. And then that tune might instantly be associated with lyrics and the usual game of things nudging each other on would come about. I've written a considerable number of songs in hotel rooms, yeah.
Your emotional chain, a calendar of meetings, strangers on the street, the best we ever arranged. Now I just can't stand all the pain, all the constant make and mend. Oh, how long can I gave you my devotion, hiding nothing up my sleeve. If I walked clean out of your life, would you even notice me? So much tangled up emotion, should I stay or should I go? Tangled up in more.